It is a world of forgotten children. Children who don't know the language or culture of their homes. Children who are picked on and bullied because of their differences. In a country that constitutionally embraces diversity and welcomes change, the children of migrant workers often find a hostile new home that has no place for them. They work the fields with no hope for a brighter tomorrow. Unless they are found, and they can be found, and educated through the Migrant Education Program. With this program, a new world of learning and understanding becomes theirs. And in this world, there is hope and a future. Beginning in the middle of the 19th century, Mexican workers immigrated to the United States by the tens of thousands, becoming field hands in the agricultural regions of this country that had, until that time, belonged to Mexico. They came in search of work that for decades was slowly dwindling in their war-ravaged homelands. With their government in shambles and the crop fields yielding smaller and smaller harvests, employment became scarce, forcing Mexican peasants to look elsewhere for survival.
There has been a huge migration of Mexican workers that have sought their opportunities in the farms of Pennsylvania. They are mostly connected from other families or relatives from them that are already here, that they may make them aware or the opportunities of work during a specific time of the year or season.
Migrant workers still chance crossing the border to gain employment and find a better life for themselves and their children. Children who are in desperate need of an education.
Our federal laws make sure that every child that comes to America has a right to a free, appropriate public education.
Regardless if the child is here for one day or for a year or all their life, we have an obligation to provide quality education to these children and provide the services to them.
With Lyndon Johnson in the White House, the United States Congress voted into law Title I of the Elementary and Secondary Education Act of 1965, allowing for migrant students to receive the education they so desperately needed.
Education is the key to the future, and the first step and the most important step these migrant children can take here in Pennsylvania is to become immersed in our education system.
The goal of the Migrant Education Program is to ensure that all migrant students reach academic standards and graduate with a high school diploma, preparing them for citizenship, further learning, and productive employment. But finding these families who live and work under the radar of traditional government programs and laws and convincing them to enroll in a government program can be tricky.
There is a big issue with trust. With the migrant families, as we know, in the past years, immigration status, immigration issues has been in the forefront, not only on the paper, on the news, on the media, but also with Congress. And parents get afraid. Parents are scared. What's going to happen to me?
We have a lot of undocumented students and parents, and it's hard for them to send them to the school because they're afraid. They are afraid that somebody might find all the information that they wrote on the paper and somebody will come and ask them for their own, you know, for the regular papers.
In a migrant's experience, once government knows they or their children are here, it's only a matter of time before they are returned to their homeland. And then it is the children who suffer.
I really feel that migrant kids are one of the most forgotten segments of the population, and I feel that they need so much help. We have a lot of kids who have a lot of potential, kids who can get, you know, where they would like to get, but they do need the help.
These children are often ghosts, invisible to our educational system, as they travel the state and the country with their parents, chasing the harvest. Sometimes these children are lost, but when they can be found and helped, they are capable of so much.
We had more than we thought.
I was born in Colombia. I was 13 years old when my mom brought us in here. She brought us in here, and it was my brother, my sister, myself, and she brought us in here for a better education. When we came here, she worked in a factory. It didn't work too well due to her language skills. She didn't speak any English. When I was in Colombia, I thought that living here was like a dream, like everybody's dream is to come here to the United States. It was very difficult, very challenging. I never thought in my life when I was in Colombia that I would come here to the United States to work in a farm.
Like parents everywhere, the migrant parents often hope for a better, easier life for their children. But that requires an education, and an education means time away from the paying jobs in the fields that ensure the family's survival. Survival for migrants is the top priority. But the migrant education program ensures that children who can't be found can be educated, paving the way for a better future.
The migrant education program is very special in that we're able to really spend time with our students and get to know what their hopes and their dreams are. We hear stories of how they're the only one that speaks Spanish in their classroom and they don't really feel anyone understands them, or they've had people tell them they'll never make it through high school or they should take the basic math and not calculus. And they've really decided that they know what they want to do and they're going to meet their goals.
Each of these children is a student during the regular school year, but their frequent moves can leave large gaps in their education. They are often left behind due to their poor English skills, struggling to follow their regular curriculum. That's where the migrant education program steps in.
Okay, now let's check what we have so far in the port.
I feel that we have a very specific function to help these kids make that transition. And the regular school system does not really help in this because they have too many kids and they don't have enough staff really to take the kids in an individual basis. And it's difficult for the school system really to meet these very special needs that a person who has been constantly moving brings along.
Their chances are very slim unless they find that role model in the school, that mentor that can help them.
As the years have passed, government restrictions have made qualifying for this important program harder and harder.
The students who are eligible go through a 3-year cycle of being eligible. Basically, the criteria that they need is, first of all, they have to move between districts. That means that they have to move from, in our area, like Northwest to Erie, or it has to cross over borders. And second of all, they have to move with their parents. That's the criteria that goes along with it. They have to make that qualifying move with their parents.
Our families aren't moving as much. Interpretations of the regulations are stricter. And it's been more challenging to identify eligible students.
migrants are finding a permanent place in the communities where they have settled. But that stability, which is typically such a good thing for children, means the students place out of the one program specifically intended to help them. If they don't move or their parents find permanent employment, they lose access to the services available to them each summer.
The fact that we only can serve them for 3 years, and that really is very sad for me, because usually when we get the family, we become very attached to them and we start working with them and we get to know them by name. We know their families, their words. You know, they're not numbers for us. They're faces with histories.
They all have stories, all have lives so extraordinary and challenging. Each of these children and their families struggle against seemingly insurmountable odds to make life in this country the dream they came chasing.
We're from Mexico. I live with my mom, my dad, and my two sisters. Both of my parents, they work. My mom and my dad, they left the house at 4 in the morning, early. And I have to be in charge with my sisters. I have to wake them up and get them into shower. And then we wait for the bus in that corner of the house. And they take us over here. The first thing that I learned here was the English. I didn't know any English words when I came.
Language is probably the biggest thing that a migrant student is going to have to overcome in their life here in the U.S. or in their educational journey. You can't communicate with the world. It's very difficult to live here in America.